name is Ingvill Konradsen Said, and I am co-founder and project, well, general manager of Prosjekt Haiti.
My name is Edwin, Luc Edwin Said, and I'm a co-founder of Prosjekt Haiti.
My name is Ragnhild Jennifer Sletner Santillere, and I work for Prosjekt Haiti. I started working for Prosjekt Haiti in 2001 when I first came to Haiti. And since then I've been volunteering, doing different kinds of work, some in Haiti but mostly in Norway, trying to inform people about what Prosjekt Haiti is about, fundraising, and also creating different activities that we can do with the children here in Haiti.
Jeg heter Åse Midtveit. I Norge så jobber jeg som frisør og har en salong som jeg driver til vanlig. Og så har jeg en jobb på Haiti hvor jeg underviser elever I frisørfaget med henblikk på å gi dem en yrkesutdannelse. Det jobben.
We started with this school here, Petit Troll in Delma in Port-au-Prince. We started to plan everything in the early months of the year 2000, and the school opened in October 2000. Prosjekt Haiti was something that we started to think about doing back in 99, I think, when I came to Haiti in 97 actually, and we started thinking that we would like to create our own project because we believe that with our network and our contacts in Norway we would be able to get some financing to start up with an educational program. We would like to make sure that the education that we provide here is of good quality. So we need to, you know, invest in good teachers. We don't want this to be a school where you kind of just place the poor children. We would like it to be a good school with good quality so that these kids can go on and, you know, really continue their education with a good background. So that's going to be very important for us. We are not only a school, I think we are able to reach out to the whole community because we train and we educate the mothers of these kids, and we actually are able to help them get jobs, and that is what most of these mothers would like, is really is to get an income so that they can pay their own bills.
Montrer pour l'école là, spécialement pour l'école là. Non, m'pa ko kable li à l'aise mais depuis c'est lettre nom qui là m'a pour moi lié. Alors c'est pour ça me plus remet là pour moi si m'te cap exploiter nom pour me graffer pour compte moi.
Dans l'école là tout parce que ça y a faire là, c'est pour nous y a faire, c'est pas pour tête tout y a faire parce que nous même nous met petit dans l'école. Nous même pour nous pas connait.
M'encourager tout moi mais maman toi là parce que s'il pas de vienne faire l'école là, là me dit que doit pas te connaître du tout.
M'ba ko faute. Toujours crabe comme on pas rentrer dans l'ia, vous comprenez? Parce que m'ba les faire faute. C'est apprendre m'a pas apprendre. Vous comprenez? Même senti bien parce que m'a gagne quelque baï m'on capable faire. Vous comprenez? M'on comprendre ni tout. Dès qu'on contrôle l'école moi, va 1 2 3 4 dans droite moi, baï ça contrôle tu baï ça. Quand j'aime capable prendre un bail là pap moi combien me gagne moi combien me rester moi ça bam temps ça bam temps
Project Haiti is a big how could we in education we start by education now we in sports like in cinema and in youth club so we have all kind of project like with the mothers it's like it's what is it in Haiti we have everything swimming the mothers sports and everything so the project is like about like it's like a movement for Haiti to give Haiti everything he needs, the youth, the people. So we work with small kids in our kindergarten, you know that from school. We work with the youth in high school. So we work with like the mothers, the fathers. So Prosjekt Haiti is about Haiti.
We have two schools with 300 children. We have a women's network with 120 women. We have a youth club. We do exchange between Norway and Haiti. We have opened two businesses and we will open a third business which will be run by women in the women's network. I think we have a total of we have more than 50 employees actually, including the employees at the bakery down the streets. And so from a small beginning we have grown very much. I think and I believe that creating jobs is maybe the most important thing, apart from education, of course.
Oh mother, hear my voice. The way my life goes, I didn't have any choice. I love when he smiles, when he smiles, I believe.
We have arranged a summer school, so a summer camp for the kids. 2 weeks every summer. We started in 2007 to do that when we had volunteers from Norway coming over, young people coming over to help us do activities for the children. We did that for 3 years and then the earthquake happened and there was really no place for us to have a summer camp. Until now, when we have this beautiful place in Saint-Louis du Sud, which is perfect for activities. So we have now, this is the second year that we are arranging summer school for the approximately 100 kids here in Saint-Louis du Sud. And this year we've had 15 Norwegian volunteers and two from New York, which is very exciting.
Well, actually part of what I do is try to find donors that would like to help us and support us. We have money from NORAD, which is the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Norway's organization. We get some money from NORAD to finance the women's projects and also the construction of the community center in Saint-Louis du Sud. But the other money that we get is from different organizations. We have a Sponsor a Child program. We have volunteer groups in Norway that collect money in different ways. Sometimes they will, you know, do a flea market or have a charity concert and stuff like that. So it really is by the help of all the volunteers in Norway, basically, that we are able to do what we're doing. And we would like to continue developing the women's projects, maybe more vocational training, different vocationals. And we would like to maybe open more bakeries and more businesses because we believe that creating work and creating jobs is a very good way of, you know, of development. For the community, we are creating jobs, and I think so it sort of goes hand in hand. The education is so important, but then what's afterwards? So to be able to think that, okay, we need the basic education, but let's see how we can try to develop and encourage mothers and family members to be part of Prosjekt Haiti so that they can get an income eventually. So I think for the whole community, we do make an impact.
I don't like Prosjekt Haiti to remain. I wish like Haiti have no Prosjekt Haiti. I wish we have no NGOs. I wish we have a normal country like United States. We don't need help. So I wish like in the near future, the whole country will not need a Prosjekt Haiti. Everybody will be together. We'll help like a normal country. That's what I want to say. I don't want to like spend the rest of my life helping people. I want them like all those kids here, they're not from ghetto. I want all those kids to have a great education. I want a system to give everything to the kid, health, education, security and everything. So that's my goal.
Children don't like to have vacation. They like to go to school. They get food at school, they get activities and they learn. Thank you.
To reach as many children as we can.